We'll start then, Prabhuji. Pradipra will start.
Yeah, maybe after introduction, Prabhuji, Prabhuji can start. So, meantime, devotee can come, you know.
Okay. Yeah, we'll just do the introduction exactly. That's
fine. Yeah.
So, we welcome Krishnanand Prabhuji. He is a current temple president of ISKCON Nasik. Prabhuji work in many capacities in the material world, especially in very high prestigious positions, like the deputy manager in Hindustan Aeronautical Limited for 5 years. He was initiated by Radhanath Maharaj, and under his directions, he's been preaching worldwide. He's also founder and director of Samruddhi School of Leadership, a special school, I think one of the unique concepts that Prabhu came out there. Which will encourage how to train and guide the teenagers. It's like a teenagers forum. It's very well received. These are motivational speakers at many conferences, which is like especially it's called Optimal Performance Technology, which is form of training of industrialists. He's spoken in several symposiums for very, very multiple industries and also very institutes. He has a beautiful book. It's called Get Set Go. It's very widely acclaimed in India. In this book, Prabhuji has explained very, very basically and very systematically that how small things can be incorporated in one's life so that one can become successful for that one. I think we are very fortunate that Prabhuji is here and we'll get a lot of guidance and knowledge from him. Thank you so much, Krishna Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. So it's my great fortune to be amongst all the devotees. And Pradyumna Prabhu told that most of you are from Baltimore. So it's my great fortune to be amongst all of you. Thank you very much, Hare Krishna. Om Ajnana Timirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshuronmilitam Yena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha. नमः ओम विष्णु पादाय कृष्ण प्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्ति वेदांत स्वामीन इति नामिने नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देश तारिणे वांछा कल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभो नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवास आदि गौर भक्त वृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे सो प्रभु जी कैन समवन अलाउ मी द राइट्स टू शेयर माय स्क्रीन
Can you allow
okay. Yeah. So Prabhuji had asked me to speak something on Chaitanya Shikshashtakam. So let me share something with all of you. I hope you can see my screen. So Hare Krishna. Welcome all. We all know that Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when he appeared around 500 years ago on this planet, he was none different than Radha and Krishna altogether. Sri Krishna Chaitanya Radha Krishna Nahi Anya. And what he has given us is unlimited. And therefore, Kaviraj Goswami mentions about him in Chaitanya Charitamrita at the very beginning. Anarpita charim charat karunaya avatirna kalau. He has appeared in this age of Kali, which no other incarnation has ever given. We all know that we have these scriptures. Bhagavad Gita is there, Srimad Bhagavatam is there, and Chaitanya Charitamrita is there. And Srila Prabhupada, he writes in his purports that for a devotee to advance in Krishna consciousness, these four books are enough. Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, Chaitanya Charitamrita, and Nectar of Devotion. You see something amazing on the slide here. There is a hierarchy and a special sequence is there. This is not only in terms of the hierarchy, what we can say, Srila Prabhupada used to mention, you know, that Bhagavad Gita is like undergraduate study, Srimad Bhagavatam is graduate study, and then Chaitanya Charitamrita is a postgraduate study. So in that sense also, it's in hierarchy, if you see, they are rising up a level. But there is also something hidden in it, why the level is rising. If you see, Bhagavad Gita starts with a very basic and fundamental spiritual truth. We are not the body, we are soul. Actual teachings of Lord Krishna starts in Bhagavad Gita 2.11. Ashochananva shochasvam prajna vadamsya bhashase gatasun agatasumsya nanu shochanti panditah. Intelligent people don't lament for the things which are not worthy of lamenting. And then we are not the body, soul, dehinosmi, athade, and teachings continue. And the whole Bhagavad Gita actually culminates in what is called as the Charam Shloka, or the zenith of the teachings of Bhagavad Gita. It's 18.66. Sarva dharman parityajya mame kam charanam raja aham tvam sarva pape bhyo mokshayishyami ma shuchah. So Bhagavad Gita ends actually. And if you see the arrow pointing upwards then. So actually, where Bhagavad Gita ends, there Srimad Bhagavatam begins actually. So where Bhagavad Gita is ending, sarva dharman parityajya mame kam charanam. Give up all varieties of religion and surrender unto me. And Srimad Bhagavatam actually starts there itself. If you open first canto, the very first chapter and the second shloka. Dharma prajita kahita vatra paramo nirmat saranam satam vedyam vastava matra vastu shivadam tapatrayon mulanam Srimad Bhagavate maha munikrute kimva parairishvaraha satyorutya varudya tetra kruti vihi susroshu vihistat kshanat. Immediately the Lord will manifest in your heart when you give oral reception to Srimad Bhagavatam. And what it does, dharma prajita kaita votra, all the Srila Prabhupada writes, kaitava dharma, cheating religions are kicked off. So where sarva dharman parityajya comes at the end of Bhagavad Gita, almost the same level it starts, dharma prajita kaita votra. And where Srimad Bhagavatam ends, Srimad Bhagavatam ends, open the 12th canto, last chapter and the last shloka of Srimad Bhagavatam. Nama sankirtanam yasya sarva papa pranashanam pranamo dukkha shamanas tam namami harimparam. Nama sankirtanam yasya sarva papa pranashanam. When you take part into the sankirtan of the Lord, sarva papa pranashanam, it destroys all your sins. And if you see where Srimad Bhagavatam is ending, actually there Chaitanya Charitamrita is beginning. Right? Sankirtan. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took birth at such an occasion where everyone would be immersed in chanting the holy names of the Lord. Sri Krishna Chaitanya Ara Prabhu Nityananda Yahara Prakashya Sarva Jagata Ananda. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu induced the entire planet to just drown in the holy name, Nama Sankirtan. So the point is, theologically, philosophically, there is a hierarchy happening here, right? And we know why Lord appears, as I mentioned in the beginning itself. What no other incarnation has given, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared to give that. When Sri Krishna was there on this planet and he completed his pastimes, did wind up, and then when he went back to the abode, he had a thought in his mind that there is something unfulfilled in my heart. What is there in me which gives so much ecstasy to Sri Radhika? And what kind of bliss she experiences? And what kind of love she possesses for me? This is still unknown. And the analogy is given. Srila Prabhupada uses this analogy in his lectures. He says that a flower is there and a bumblebee is there. So the bumblebee can enjoy the juice of the flower, but the flower itself cannot. So for the flower to enjoy its own juice, rasa, it has to become a bumblebee. So similarly, Lord Krishna decided to become Radharani, but how he will become? There has to be something. So there was a time for incarnation to appear, yuga avatar, and then Krishna himself in the mood and kanti, that is color of Srimati Radharani, he appeared as Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and that is being glorified by Kaviraj Goswami in CC Adi Leela, the very beginning verses. Radha Krishna Pranaya Vikriti Ladini Shakti Rasmat Ekatmano Api Bhuipura Deha Bhedam Gatautau Chaitanyakyam Prakatam Adunata Dvayam Chaikyam Aptam Radha Bhava Dyuti Suvalitam Naomi Krishna Swarupam. Radha and Krishna, they are Ekatmano Api Bhuipura. They were one before. There is only one Tattva, Supreme Truth. It has manifested into two, Radha and Krishna. And then Chaitanyakyam Prakata Madhuna, they both became one in the form of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So Radha, Bhava and Jyoti. The Bhava of Srimati Radharani and the Jyoti of Srimati Radharani. And Lord Krishna himself has appeared. I bow down to that Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So these are the three internal reasons Kaviraj Goswami explains for the appearance of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. There are three external reasons and three internal reasons for the appearance of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So the three internal reasons are mentioned in this verse, Adi Leela, first chapter, sixth text. Sri Radhaya Pranaya Mahima Kidrusho Vanayaiva Aswadyo Yena Adbhut Madurima Kidrusho Vamadiyah Saukhyam Chasya Madanubahuta Kidrusham Vetilo Bhattad Bhavadya Samajani Shachigarva Sindhau Harindu. Sri Radhayaha Pranaya Mahima. Kidrusho. Kidrusho means of what type? What? Radhayaha Pranaya Mahima. What kind of love Srimati Radharani possesses? Aswadyo yena adbhut madhurima. Kidrusho va madhiya. What type of madhurima? What type of sweetness is there in me that it astonishes Srimati Radharani? And saukhyam chasya mad anubhavatah kidrusham vektido bhat. And when she experiences, when she get attracted by my qualities, she feels happy. What kind of happiness she experiences? I want to experience that. Tad bhavadya. So that bhav, these three types of consciousness were induced. And samajani shachigarbha sindhau harindu. See the beauty of, in the composition by Kaviraj Goswami. Shachigarbha means the garbha of Mother Shachi. It's called a Sindhu, ocean. Like from the ocean, the moon takes birth, it seems, and the moon rises from the ocean. So similarly, Harinduhu means the moon of Lord Chaitanya has taken birth from the ocean of Garbh of Mother Shachi. And when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared, we all know that whole Chaitanya Charitamrita is divided into actually three sections, Adi Leela, Madhya Leela, and Antya Leela. Adi Leela has got 17 chapters, Madhya Leela has got 25 chapters, and Antya Leela has got 20 chapters each. So I am telling you, I have told you the hierarchy of Gita, Bhagavad, and CC. And in CC also, it's in and itself there is a hierarchy. First is Adi Leela, then is Madhya Leela, then is Antya Leela. So actually, An means that which is in Adi means that which is in the beginning. Madhya is that which is in the middle. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's birth and till marriage, and after that till sannyas, things are explained in Adilila. Then after taking sannyas, Mahaprabhu goes to Jagannath Puri on the order of his mother. Otherwise, he wanted to go to Vrindavan. And he stays for some time in Jagannath Puri and then keeps traveling to various places like South India, Dakshin Bharat, and then Vrindavan, and then again going back to Jagannath Puri. So Adilila, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu lived on this planet for total of 48 years. And first 24 years of his life are covered in Adilila, and then latter 24 are divided into Madhya and Antya. So in that, first 6 years are attributed or basically mentioned in Madhya Lila. First 6 years, Gamana Gaman, he traveled to various places. And in the latter remaining 18 years are basically part of his Antya Lila. So in those 18 years also, 6 years he would meet devotees, like devotees from Bengal and all the other places, Srikhanda. They all used to go to Jagannath Puri to meet Lord Chaitanya, be there for 4 months and then come back. We all read in Antalya. Shivanand Sen used to take all the devotees. So there they would dance in front of Rath Yatra and so many things. Sweet pastimes are mentioned. But in the latter 12 years, actually, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu used to be in close association of his close associates, like Ramanand Rai or Sarvam Bhattacharya, like them, and used to spend time in isolation, relishing the mood of Srimati Radharani. So that is the highest rasa, actually. And that highest rasa is explained in Antya Lila. And in the Antya Lila, Mahaprabhu was always used to feel ecstasy. And he used to just do that aswadan, you know, rasa aswadan of that Lila. And during that ecstatic state, he used to recite some verses, and Sri Chaitanya Shikshastak is part of those verses. It is not that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has written those verses. In his ecstasy, he would just sing the close associates like Ramanand Rai and Swarup Damodar. They would listen, and then they narrated to Rupa Goswami, who has mentioned these 8 verses in Padyavali. And then later Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami mentions in Chaitanya Charitamrita as well. So these are 8 verses, not written exactly 8. See, Mahaprabhu wanted to give some shiksha. These are my teachings. Follow this. No. They are not like Bhagavad Gita kind of teachings. They are like a kind of a bhajan kind of teachings, you know. Like we have these bhajans. Bhajahure mana srinandanandana. Abhaya charanara bindare. So when we sing these bhajans, actually they are teachings to our own mind. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, in his ecstasy, he would teach his own mind. And these teachings, teaching in English is called as shiksha. So teachings to the mind, actually, they are in the mood of intercontemplation and relishing those. So instructions given by oneself to oneself. So these are Chaitanya Shikshastak prayers. So very wonderful, beautiful, and it's the heart of all Gaudiya Vaishnavas. So etymologically, if you want to divide, some of the words in my slide, you will find in Devanagari, Sanskrit. Most of them are in English, I have prepared for you. But some I have kept them intact in Devanagari to capture that mood over there. So Shiksha Ashtak, if you break down Shiksha and Ashtak. Shiksha means basically instructions, and Ashtak means 8. So eight instructions in line. They're called as Shiksha Ashtakam. Ashtakam, we have so many Ashtakams, right? We have Harir Nama Ashtakam, glorifying the Holy Name. We have Damodar Ashtakam, which all devotees fondly sing during Kartik. We have Jagannath Ashtakam, which is sung during Lord Jagannath festival. So like there are so many Ashtakams, eight verses. So Shiksha Ashtakam is the eight verses which are given as instructions for one's own mind. So now we can all recite together these eight verses. They are very wonderful. And maybe I can share with you first the benefit of this recitation. Then you will have what we can say, a mood and a motivation to do that. After mentioning these eight verses and explaining their meanings as well, Kaviraj Goswami, Antalila, as I mentioned, there are 20 chapters and it comes in the last chapter. So in the 20th chapter, after explaining all these eight verses, Kaviraj Goswami gives the benediction. What is the benediction? He gives in the end, I give in the beginning. Prabhura Shikshashtaka Shloka Yei Padeshune Krishna Prema Bhakti Tara Bade Dine Dine. So sweet. You must have understood. Prabhura Shikshashtaka Shloka. These eight verses given by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Prabhura Shikshashtaka Shloka Yei Padeshune. Anyone who reads and anyone who shune, anyone who hears, what happens to that person? Krishna Prema Bhakti Tara of that person. The Krishna bhakti and the love for the Lord in his heart, bade dine dine, every day it increases. And therefore, if you see beautifully, Srila Prabhupada has included these prayers in the morning program itself. In most of the temples, after Mangalarti, Narasimharti, and Tulsiarti, Chaitanya Shikshashtakam is sung. So, Prabhupada believed firmly on this, that anyone who reads and hears these prayers, actually the love for the Lord and the devotion they have, it will increase day by day by day by day by day. So if you want love for the Lord and the devotion for the Lord to increase, then just recite these beautiful verses. So we can begin by reciting these verses. We can all recite together.
चेतो दर्पणमार्जनं भवमहादावाग्निनिर्वापणं श्रेयः कैरवचन्द्रिका वितरणं विद्यावधू जीवनं आनन्दाम्बुदिवर्धनं प्रतिपदं पूर्णामृतास्वादनं सर्वात्मस्नपनं परं विजयते श्रीकृष्णसङ्कीर्तनम् नामनामकारि बहुधा निज सर्वशक्तिस्तत्रार्पितानि अमितस्मरणेन कालः एतादृशी तव कृपा भगवन् ममापि दुर्दैवमीदृशमिहाजनिनानुरागः तृणादपि सुनीचेन तरोरपि सहिष्णुना अमानिना मानदेना कीर्तनीया सदा हरिः न धनं न जनं न सुन्दरीं कवितां वा जगदीशकामये मम जन्मनि जन्मनीश्वरे भवताद् भक्तिरहेतुके त्वयि अयि नन्दतनुज किङ्करं पतितं मां विषमे भवाम्बुधौ कृपया तव पादपङ्कज स्थितधूलिसदृशं विचिन्तय नयनं गलदश्रुधारय वदनं गद्गद्हृदयागिर पुलकैर्निचितं वपुः कदा तव नाम ग्रहणे भविष्यति युगायितं निमेषेण चक्षुषा प्रावृषायितं शून्यायितं जगत् सर्वं गोविंद विरहेण मे आश्लिष्य वा पादरतां पिनश्रु मां अदर्शनान् मर्महतां करोतु वा यथा तथा वा विदधातु लंपटो मत्प्राणनाथस्तु सेवनापरः. So these are these eight verses and one more shloka from CC again, Antalila 20th chapter. पूर्वे अष्ट श्लोक करी लोके शिक्षा दिला से अष्ट श्लोकेर अर्थ आपने आस्वाद दिला. तो चैतन्य महाप्रभु पूर्वे इन द प्रीवियसली इट्सेल्फ अष्ट श्लोक करी लोके शिक्षा दिला. चैतन्य महाप्रभु प्रीवियसली इट्सेल्फ ही हैज इंस्ट्रक्टेड दीज वर्सेस टू मेनी लाइक वी सी दैट तुनादर पी सुनीचे न कम्स वेल बिफोर व्हेन चैतन्य महाप्रभु मेट रूप सनातन रघुनाथ दास गोस्वामी देर इटसेल्फ दिस तुनादर पी श्लोक कम्स महाप्रभु इंस्ट्रक्टेड देम सही अष्ट श्लोके अर्थ आपने आस्वादिला एंड द सेम एट वर्सेस ही रिलीज्ड व्हेन ही वाज इन हिज लेटर पास्ट टाइम्स. सो दिस शिक्षाष्टकम प्रेयर्स आई जस्ट वांटेड टू शेयर समथिंग. You all must be reciting daily. You are all very advanced souls. And if you want, these all these eight verses are there in Chaitanya Charitamrita and there are beautiful explanation given by Srila Prabhupada. I just wanted to share something that there are so many commentaries written by our previous acharyas on just these eight verses. Bhaktivinoda Thakur has written a commentary and it is entitled as Sri Sanmodaya Bhashya. When Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur also wrote a separate commentary on eight verses, it's called Vivritti Tika. And based on this, I just wanted to tell something about these eight verses and how they are placed and how important they are, so that you can daily recite them and dive deep into their meanings and try to apply also. So Chaitanya Shikshastram is called as the essence of all these Vedas. And the division of these verses of Shikshastakam is done. So how they are divided, you see in the green, they are divided based on these two aspects. The first aspect is based on the three types of knowledge described in the Vedas. And the second division is based on the level of bhakti. So if we begin, let us see the first division based on the three types of knowledge described in the Vedas. So Vedas describes this, all the knowledge basically contained in the Vedas can be broadly classified into again three categories: Sambandha Gyan, Abhideya Gyan, and Prayojan Gyan. Krishna Sambandha Bhakti Abhideya Hai Prema Prayojana Vede Tina Vastu Kai. In Vedas only three things are described. Kaviraj Goswami explains Krishna Sambandha. Knowledge about Krishna is Sambandha Gyan. Bhakti Abhideya Hoy. Knowledge about Bhakti is Abhideya. And Prema Prayojan. Prem is Prayojan. So, who am I? Who is Lord? The last relationship between the two, that is Sambandha Gyan. How do I revive that last relationship with the Supreme Lord by doing Bhakti? That is Abhideya Gyan. And what is the fruit of that practice? The love of the Lord, which is then revived in the heart of a conditioned soul, that is Prayojana. So Vedas talked about these three categories of knowledge only: Sambandha Gyan, Abhideya Gyan, and Prayojana Gyan. Once I did a seminar based on Bhagavad Gita, and these three leveled understanding from Bhagavad Gita. So Gita verses also, if you see and note, they can be classified in these three categories. Sambandha Gyan. Mama evamsho jiva loke jiva bhuta sanatana. These are my part and parcel. So 15.7 is Sambandha Gyan. Abhideya Gyan. What is need to be done to revive that relationship? Manmana bhavmat bhakto madhya jimam namaskuru. 9.34. So many verses are actually. Ananya cheta asatvam yomam smrti nityashah. So Abhideya. And Prayojan. What is the fruit of that? yad gatva na nivartante tad dhama parmam 15.6. So you attain that abode from which there is no return. So all the scriptures can be basically divided into these three. So Shikshashtakam also in one sense divided into these three. And they are, or basically, they should be known to everyone. And based on the level of bhakti, second division, if we see, so bhakti also has various levels. The first is sadhana bhakti, next is bhava bhakti, and then we have prema bhakti. Basically, there is a process which is called as sadhana. The person who is undergoing that sadhana is called as sadhak. And one who has perfected this sadhana is called as siddha. So sadhak, sadhana, and siddhi. So sadhak is at the beginning, sadhana bhakti. As he advances, he attains the stage of bhava bhakti. And then the mature fruit of bhava bhakti is called as prema bhakti. So that is the highest, which we call love of God. And various examples also, if you see, Bharat Maharaj's example comes in Srimad Bhagavatam. It is mentioned that he was at the level of bhava bhakti. And there are symptoms also to understand who is at what level. Dhruva Maharaj did tapasya for 6 months and then he obtained the Lord. So that kind of tapasya comes in sadhana bhakti. And prema bhakti, basically all those pure devotees and their bhakti, like Yashoda Mata, Srimati Radharani, that is a prema bhakti. So sadhana bhakti is in the beginning, advanced stage is bhava bhakti, and then the perfected stage is basically a prema bhakti. So all these three, based on these three, also there is a division of these eight verses. And these three are also basically defined by Rupa Goswami in Bhaktir Samrut Sindhu, based on the teachings he received from Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in Dashashwamedh Ghat for non-stop 10 days. He has written those definitions. So Bhaktir Samrut Sindhu is nothing but a book of definitions. So he has written those definitions there. And based on that, Kaviraj Goswami has extracted some things from them. And these definitions of these bhakti we can found in CC as well as Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu. So sadhana bhakti, what is sadhana bhakti? Kruti sadhya bhavet sadhya bhava sa sadhana vidha nitya siddhasya bhavasya prakatya murdi sadhyata. When a transcendental devotional service by which love for Krishna is attained is executed by the senses, it is called sadhana bhakti or the regulated discharge of devotional service. Such a devotion externally exist, such devotion eternally exists within the heart of every living entity, nitya siddhasya bhavasya. And the awakening of this eternal devotion is the potentiality of devotional service in practice. So what is there in the heart? Nitya siddha krishna prema sadhya kabunaye shavanadi shuddha chitte koraye udaye. So that nitya siddha, it is always established in the heart. And then through our execution by our external senses, what we practice, that love is evoked. That is called as sadhana bhakti. What is bhava bhakti? Shuddha sattva visheshatma prema suvyamshu samya bhag vruchi bhis chitta masrunya krudasau bhava uchyate. This is the definition of bhava bhakti. When devotional service is executed on the transcendental platform of pure goodness, it is a like sunray of love for Krishna. At such time, devotional service causes the heart to be softened by various tastes, and one is then situated in bhava. You know this bhava, chitta masrunya krit. So the heart is softened, and we see the symptoms. You know, there are tears coming in the eyes, hair standing on the end in the body. So these are the symptoms of bhava bhakti. So bhava bhakti, if we consider a bud of a flower, then prema bhakti is the fully blossomed flower. The definition is also samyak masrunita स्वान्तो ममत्वातिशयांकितः भाव स एव सांद्रात्मा बुधहि प्रेमानि गद्यते. When that bhava softens the heart completely, samyak masranito swanto, complete softening of the heart and becomes endowed with the great feeling of possessiveness in relation to the Lord. Mamatva atishaya ankita. Mamatva means mine. So the Lord is mine. That consciousness is so full in that devotee. So the feeling of possessiveness in relation to the Lord and becomes very much condensed and intensified. Sandratma. It is so condensed that nothing can pierce it. That is called as love by the learned scholars. Budhai prema anikantete. Intelligent people call that as prema. It's sandrananda visheshatma, you know. So that is basically a prema bhakti. So now what we have seen is devotion, division of these verses based on these two. So one is based on the three types of knowledge described in the Vedas. And what are these three types of knowledges? Sambandha, Videya and Prayojan. And what is the second? Based on level of bhakti. And what are the three levels of bhakti? Sadhan bhakti, bhava bhakti and prema bhakti. Now with these understanding, let us move again to Shikshashtak prayers. And here comes the chant in front of all of us. So division of verses of Shikshashtakam is there. So eight verses are there. So verse number you will find on the extreme left. Then each verse has a topic. The first verse talks about Cheto Darpana Marjanam, we know. The effect of chanting of the holy names of the Lord. Second verse talks about our misfortune. Nam Namakari Bahuda, Nija Sarva Shakti. You have endured all the potency, but na anuragaha, but I don't have developed taste for it. That is my misfortune. Third one is the process by which one should chant. Fourth is the desire of a sadhaka, what a sadhaka wants, na dhanam, na janam, na sundari. Fifth is the nature of a sadhaka. Sixth is the external symptoms of a perfected state. And the seventh is the internal symptoms of the perfected state. And the eighth verse talks about the complete surrender. Now, what these two classifications we just now discussed. So first was based on the level of bhakti. So if you see the level of bhakti, the first five verses talks about sadhana bhakti. Right? How sadhana should be performed. More advanced stage, sixth verse. Sixth verse beginning with Nainam Galadashru Dharya is actually state of Bhava Bhakti, right? So external and internal symptoms, sixth and seventh verses are classified in Bhava Bhakti category. And then the seventh and eighth, these two goes into the category of Prema Bhakti. So first five in the category of Sadhana Bhakti, sixth and seventh in the category of Bhava Bhakti, and seventh and eighth in the category of Prema Bhakti. Now, based on three types of knowledges which are described in the Veda, Sambandha, Videya and Prayojan, if you see, again the first verses gives us the Sambandha Gyan. Sambandha Gyan. Something about us, something about the Lord and yeah. And what is the Prayojan? The fruit of love of Godhead. So 6 to 8 verses talks about Prayojan. And all the eight verses are classified as Abhideya. What is Abhideya? Abhideya is process of reviving our love towards Lord. So all these eight verses talked about the process. Glorifying the holy name is itself a process. So all these eight can be classified under Abhideya. So again, I'll repeat. Based on the level of bhakti, first five verses are categorized as sadhan bhakti, sixth and seventh as bhava bhakti, seventh and eighth as prema bhakti. And based on three levels, three types of knowledge, sambandha, bideya, prayojan, first five talks about sambandha, last three talks about prayojan, and all the eight talks about abhideya. So in nutshell, what we discussed today, just a quick summary. We talked about this Shikshashtakam, appearance of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, why he appeared on the planet, and then the hierarchy of the books, Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavatam, Chaitanya Charitamrita, where Gita ends, Bhagavatam starts, where Bhagavatam ends, Chaitanya Charitamrita starts, and Chaitanya Charitamrita also has three divisions, Adi, Madhya and Antya. And Chaitanya Shikshastak prayers are found in the Antya chapter of the Antya Lila, last chapter of the Antya Lila. So deep they are, imbued with a lot of meaning. And then we saw Shiksha and Ashtakam, the etymological meaning, instructions, but they are not instructions like Gita, you should do this, you should do that. They are instructions like bhajan, given to the mind, and which devotees should follow. And we saw the benefit of reciting Prabhura Shikshastaka Shloka Yai Padeshune Krishna Prema Bhakti Tara Vade Dine Dine. If you recite these verses, then your bhakti and love for the Lord will increase day by day. So daily one should recite and contemplate and meditate on these prayers. And then we recited those eight prayers. And then we saw the division of these eight prayers actually based on level of bhakti first, sadhan bhakti, bhava bhakti and prema bhakti. And then later, later based on the three types of knowledges described in the Veda, sambandha, kyan, abhideya, jnana and prayojan. So that division chart is there in front of all of you here. So that's all I wanted to share with all of you. Any question anyone has?
Hare Krishna. If any devotee has any question, please feel free and ask the question. And you can unmute yourself and ask the question. Please. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji, Dandavat Pranam. Thank you so much Prabhuji for sharing the reasons why we have to recite Shikshashtakam prayers and also such much more deeper meanings of the stages of bhakti. The question I have Prabhuji is, are those verses in sequence, say you mentioned that the first four or five verses are related to sadhana bhakti as a practicing devotee. How a devotee needs to meditate on those verses? Is it sequential? Like
yes.
One verse at a time, or how does it, can you please explain Prabhuji?
Yeah, it is sequential. As I mentioned, that first five talks about sadhana bhakti, then bhava bhakti, and then prema bhakti. So these are our aspirations. So when we, and that is the sequence also. Bhakti also flows in a sequence. Sadhana bhakti, then bhava bhakti, and prema bhakti. There is a sequence. So these prayers also have us, actually Kaviraj Goswami has put them in a sequence, basically. He has put them in a sequence. They were haphazard in the beginning. Mahaprabhu would recite as per his bhava. And then they were collected by his close associates and then presented systematically by Kaviraj Goswami. And we know, all know, Kaviraj Goswami is such a systematic man, you know. He gives references and everything systematic he does. So he has done that sequence. And if we also need to chant those prayers in sequence and make progress sequentially. Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Prabhuji. Hare Krishna.
Thank you.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji, are you following the every Sunday this the Shikshashtaka, eight prayers? The Shikshashtaka prayers, are you going to one by one every time? The first verse and then second verse in detail, would you be enlightening us with that?
Yeah, they are mentioned by Kaviraj Goswami, and he himself has glorified and extended, given some explanations. So if you want some explanations, you can just go through Chaitanya Charitamrita Antya Lila 20th chapter. After every verse, there are 4-5 verses given. And there are many speakers who have talked on them.
Yeah. I like to hear your realizations.
Regarding
regarding these verses?
What I do is daily, I recite them before chanting. And as it is a part of a morning program in the temple itself, but now the temple is closed because of lockdown. But still before chanting, we recite. And I found that when I recite these verses, actually I feel that deep connection to Holy Name and Lord Chaitanya. Because he has given us for us to meditate upon. And when we, and as it is mentioned, you know, we should have this faith in the words of Acharya. Like Kaviraj Goswami himself is giving a blessing, right? Krishna yes. Prema Bhakti Dada Bade Dine Dine. Every day your bhakti will increase. And so we can feel that if you recite it daily. Keep reciting daily. Before chanting of the Holy Name, what you can do is, sometimes I used to practice this. Before every new round, chant one prayer and meditate on the meaning of the prayer and then begin your next round. Now imagine if you just recite this second verse of Shikshashtak. Namnama kari bahudana shakti. Right?
Yes.
Putrarpita niyamita smaranena kala. My Lord has so many names and you have infused all your energy in those names. Nija sarva shakti. Now imagine the kind of shakti Lord has, the all kinds of creative energy, the destroying energy, and all these energies are manifested in the name, the Tatrarpita. And though the name is so powerful, niyamita smaranena kala, there is no rule for chanting. When should chant, where should chant, how to chant, there are no absolute rules for chanting. Etadrushi tava krupa bhagavan mamapi. You have been merciful on me to such an extent, my Lord, but see my misfortune. Durdaiva vidrusha mihatanina anuraga. I don't have taste for chanting, my Lord. So when we sing these prayers, you know, we automatically dive deep into the mood and then we feel that misfortune and let me be fortunate by being attentive to chanting the Holy Name and not commit offenses. So we automatically become attentive by meditating on the meaning. So you can also try practicing that before every new round, meditate on one prayer of Shikshashtak.
Yes,
so eight rounds can be done, good quality rounds, right?
Thank you, Prabhuji. Actually, I try to do Santuva for first two rounds, one verse, then second two rounds, another second verse, and like that, chant before starting.
Yeah, try that. Mm-hmm. You'll feel the difference.
Thank you, Prabhuji, very nice. I'd like to hear you more again. May come again, give nice class like this.
Thank you. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Harinam, Kirtan Prabhu has something to say, I think.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji, Dhanvat Pranam. Thank you so much for beautifully explaining the Shikshastakam, glory, stages. So whenever I read or hear Shikshastakam, I recite daily. So I always somehow the quality of Tararopi Sahishnuna, the tolerance, like it's very difficult to understand a devotee, whatever calamities or difficulties is going through, should tolerate it. Because it's if somebody speaks harsh to you, even that creates grudges in our hearts. And we are ready to argue some things or what to talk of somebody, you know, insult or physically assault or many, many places, you know, devotees goes through that era as well. And this principle of tolerance, it's just by the mercy of the Lord, or how should we accept it? Like, I'm just not very clear. Please, you can give some nice explanation on this. Thank you.
Good question. That many a times we hear these verses and then we feel them to be at this level and we are at this level when we try to apply them. So how to go about this? First of all, we should know what is high level and ideal level expected of me and accept the reality where I am. this itself will make us humble. First of all, because I am not at that level, right? I am at this level. I accept. Now, after accepting, we don't have to stay at that level. We need to rise, right? I need to go to that level, high level, though it seems high. And when we read scriptures, actually, then we see so many examples, right? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu made Haridas Thakur as Namacharya. See his life, so tolerant, like beaten 22 marketplaces, and still he was forgiving those people who were beating him. And actually, Prabhupada writes in one purport in Bhagavad Gita, he says, the greatness of a person is estimated by his ability to tolerate provoking situations. Very nice statement by Prabhupada. The greatness of a person has to be estimated by his ability to tolerate provoking situations. So we will be provoked. So that is our test. If we pass, then we move towards greatness. And if we don't pass, then we stay there where we are. So somehow or the other, and Kaviraj Goswami himself gives these examples of a tree, you know, Tarovariva Sahishnuna, being tolerant like a tree. Tree doesn't, Maria Katia, anyone who throws stones to that fellow also, tree gives shade and fruits. And if no one waters the roots of a tree, it doesn't ask for water. It will die, but will never ask for water. Give me water. Have you seen tree crying? Give me water, give me water. No. They will die, but never ask for water. And they will always give shade. Anyone who comes, stays there, they offer their shade. Anyone who cuts, for them also, they are always useful. So if we develop this attitude that, yes, we need to be tolerant to what happens to us, but when it comes to institution or other devotees, then that need not be tolerated. If someone says, you know, your mission is like this and say some bad names, then you can defend, obviously. Krodha bhakta dveshi gane. That is being said. How you employ your anger to those who are bhakta dveshi, those who are hating devotees. So we need to be tolerant to all that is happening to us. Like Pandavas, they tolerated, right? So many ill treatments given by Duryodhan, Dhritarashtra party, they tolerated. But at one point they had to take a call and fight. So Krishna was there, and based on Krishna's instructions, they fought. So anything, if adharmic things are there, then in the name of being humble, we need not tolerate. Like Hanumanji, who was emblem of humility, but he burned the Lanka, right? And Hanumanji is a very peculiarity. If you see his pose, he's standing like this, folding hands, and in his hand he is holding club like this, you know. You see Hanuman's pose, he's folding hand and club in his hand. I don't have a club, I have bottle only, I can show this like this. So bowing hands means it's a kind of humility to Lord Ram, and ready to take club for the mission of Lord Ram. Right? So for the mission of Lord, he's always ready to act, whatever may be the reason. So it's not that he's not humble. He's so humble. It's not that Srila Prabhupada was not humble. He was humble. He used to say that these people are more advanced. You disciples, you are sent by my guru. But while preaching, he was so bold, right? These rascals, and he would use those terms, right? So basically, we need to understand humility and tolerance. They are things to be implemented as per time, place, and circumstances. And we need to always develop these qualities if we really want to advance in life. I hope it throws some light on your question.
Thank you, Prabhu. Thank you for nicely explaining the difference and where to act and where not to act. Thank you, Prabhu. Hare Krishna.
Welcome. Thank you. So we can stop.
Hare Krishna Prabhu. If you have a few minute time, then if you can discuss about your Nasik temple, what deity you have in the temple, because we don't know about Nasik, and something you can say a few minutes just past time, you know, about Lord Ramchandra ji was there in Nasik.
And just a second. I think you can see now. These are deities in Nasik temple.
Yes.
They are Sri Sri Radha.
What are the names?
Sri Sri Radha Madan Gopal.
Jai Radha Madan Gopal ki jai.
And
beautiful deity. Nice.
Beautiful.
They dress themselves very nicely.
Very nice deity.
So we have this Sri Sri Radha Madan Gopal ji temple in Nasik, and Nasik is a very holy place. You might be knowing that there are Kumbh Mela places in India. Ujjain is there, Haridwar is there, one Allahabad is there, and Nasik is there. So if you read Chaitanya Charitamrita Madhya Lila while Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was taking Dakshin Bharat South Indian tour, he came to Nasik.
Yay.
So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came, took a bath in Ramkunda. We have, so if we go back in the history, Lord Ram actually when exiled, and after Chitrakut, he went to Dandakaranya forest. So this whole area was under Dandakaranya forest. So Lord Ram stayed here. It is said that almost like last part of his exile was here only in Nasik. And there is river, beautiful river Godavari, on which the Kumbh Mela takes place. And beautiful temple of Lord Ram is there. The same place from where Mother Sita was abducted by Ravana, that place is also there.
Oh, really?
Uh-huh. And we know that there is a place called as Panchavati where Lord Ram would reside in a forest grove. And we all know that Lakshmana cut off the nose of Shurpanakha. Right? When she came, the same place is there in Nasik.
Oh.
Actually, the place where the whole pastime occurred is like Tapovan area, Tapovan. Where austerities are performed, Tapovan, there is a river in between and then the other side of the river. So when it is said that the nose of Shurpanakha was cut up by Lakshman and thrown on the other side of the river, so the nose in Sanskrit is called as Nasika. So the place of Nasik became Nasik.
That's why name is Nasika.
That's right. So the other side is Tapovan, then the river, and then the other side of the river is Nasik. So Lord Ram stayed here. And they used to take bath in Ram Kunda. That Kunda is still there. And on the very same place, Kumbh Mela take place. Close to Nasik is Trambakeshwar, which is one of the 12 Jyotirlingas of Lord Shiva. Magnificent temple is there. And there are so many small, small other temples in Nasik. Surya Narayan temple is there and all. And close to Nasik, there's a place, village called as, it's in Nasik only, Taked place, where Jatayu had a fight with Ravana.
Oh, wow.
And
Jatayu's wings were cut off and Jatayu left his body and Lord Ram, while searching for Mother Sita, they performed the last rites of Jatayu. So that Jatayu's temple is still there in Taked. It's hardly 50 kilometers from Nasik city. The only temple of Lakshman alone in the entire world is in Tapovan, in Nasik, where the diorama is exhibiting Lakshman cutting the nose of Shurpanakha. And his beautiful temple is also there in Tapovan. In Kumbh Mela, lakhs of people come here. And we have a small temple, Sri Sri Radha Madan Gopal temple. Preaching started in Nasik in 1996. All these great sannyasis were there for the Kumbh Mela. And Radhanath Swami then asked one of them that, why don't you come for preaching and establish a center here? So Paramahamsa Prabhu, who was then Brahmacharya at Radha Gopinath temple, was deputed here to, for preaching. And then he established so much of preaching. Now he is director of Bhaktivedanta Hospital, if you know, Mumbai. And then later on, so many other devotees started coming. Then Shikshashtakam Prabhu was given the charge of this temple from Chaupati. And he is now there. And under his leadership, we are all functioning. And we have 30 brahmacharis here and a congregation of around 600-700 devotees.
Oh, wow. That's
good. Just attending, nice.
Attending the weekly programs. And yeah, that's all.
Very nice. Very nice progress, Prabhuji.
Hope we can come one day over there.
Yeah. Is what is there exactly in Panchvati nowadays? Panchvati has something.
Panchvati has a beautiful and ancient temple of Lord Ram to be visited. It is said that the deity of Lord Ram is installed by Brahmaji there. So that beautiful temple is there. Sita Gumpha is there, where Mother Sita used to stay in that kuti. You know Vata Vriksha?
Yes.
Vata.
Right.
So, banyan trees, right?
Yeah.
So, the five of them are there. It is said that those five trees have witnessed Lord Ram's pastimes. Panchavati means...
Right, that's
it. Five Vata Vriksha.
Very nice.
That is there. River is there. Godavari, Ramkunda is there. Trambakeshwar is there. Taker is there. So 2-3 days. There are so many devotees from India as well as abroad. They keep coming for tours, and 2-3 days they stay here. There are various guest houses made. Unfortunately, ISKCON doesn't have a guest house here. Soon we will also come up with a guest house. And yeah, they come, they stay, and they have the tour of the dham. And then they go surcharged.
Yeah, right.
So they have, is there some guest houses that people, the visitors can stay there?
We don't have guest house in our temple, but there are so many outside guest houses where we have contacts. And our devotees are there who can who take care of guest receptions and all that.
Thank you very much Prabhuji.
You have very nicely explained and we really enjoy your association. Please come again and we will invite you again for near future. Thank you very much, Hare Krishna. And thank you. You have explained about Nasik. I never thought about Nasik, meaning of Nasik, you know, and then you have explained the pastime, you know, so it's very, very beautiful. Thank you again.
There are so many pastimes, but there is no time to narrate.
Right. Okay.
Maybe when you come to Nasik, that time you can listen.
Right, definitely. We will come.
Yes.
Someday when Lord permit, you know, when Corona crisis is over and, you know, everything is normal, right?
No one is able to travel these days. But at least Mansik, you can, you know, like.
Right.
Hearing.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. Jai
Shri Krishna. Thank you very much, Prabhu. Vancha Kalpataru
Prashtra.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Prabhuji.
Thank you.